All right, welcome to the Photography 4-H Basics. And this is presented by Jefferson County Extension 4-H and with the help of University of Florida, Jefferson County, Florida, and the FAMU Cooperative Extension. This is a little program designed to get you to start thinking about how to edit photos. And there are a lot of free programs out there. There are different ways you can edit a photo depending on what software you use, but there are a lot of free ones, especially on your phone. There are a whole lot of free apps that you can do, which will help a lot. Like Snapseed, for instance, is one of them. And you can get not just on your iPhone, but on your iPad as well. But there are little extension gadgets that you can plug into your phone. But this is just a very general basic. There are so many different things you can do editing. You can take telephone poles and you can manipulate faces. Obviously, there's a lot of apps out there that you can do all kinds of funny things with pictures. However, this is just going to be a simple, straightforward, basic level information. So you can take a photo and make it slightly better. The first thing to do is always to just try your best to have as best quality as you can photo originally. However, if it's slightly dark or slightly light, or if you want the colors to stand out a little bit more, or maybe something else about the photo, maybe you want to crop some of it out in order to make it a better photo, that's what you look for. So I will start from here and go into it. Alrighty. If my slideshow will cooperate with me. Okay, so basic photo editing. And hopefully everything is coming through all right. But this is a photography editing. And what I do when I first get my photos after I shoot them is I take the SD card, take it out, and most computers nowadays have a way of downloading your pictures onto your computer. They have a little slot that is on a mobile computer as well as your tower computers. And you just put it in and it will pop up and say, do you want to import your photos? And you go, yes. And I would keep all your photos. I would always, no matter what you're doing with editing, I would always keep the original photo. Just edit it and make a new copy of it. And so you can just get rid of the edit if you need to. If you change the original, you can't go backwards. So always keep original photo. What I do is after I download all my photos is I go through them. Which ones do I want to keep? Are they good? Are they bad? Can I use this for what I'm doing? If it's for Facebook, the pictures have to be smaller, so there's not going to be as much information. It'll take up less space. However, if you're doing a photo contest photo, what you're going to want is a photo that has as much information as you can, and they're called raw photos. There are cameras out there that shoot in raw. Most of them, however, don't shoot in raw, but they shoot in another format, and you want as many pixels as you can in a photograph. And your camera has settings on them to make it so there are several thousand by several thousand pixels. And it has to deal with the pixel ratio of your photograph, and I'm not going to go into it, but just the bigger and the more info a photo has, the better quality it will come out as. If you have a smaller photo, like 100 by 200, then yeah, it's going to come out very distorted. If you try to magnify it or blow it up, it's going to look very pixelated and look really, really bad. And your photo will not come out right. So just make sure that you're using the right thing. Which photos do you like? Also, you want to use photos that emit emotion. Like, it's really a good thing to edit photos that bring about something. Like, if it's your uncle's or granddad's 100th birthday, or if it's a very memorable moment where you hit your first home run, or I mean, those are the kinds of photos that a judge will more than likely go to first. So just those are the ones that you want to edit and make sure that they're good. But I go through them and do they have bad lighting? Is there a way to salvage them? Is the composition good? With a little bit of cropping and editing, can I make a bad photo look decent? There's only so much an editing software can do. So it's always good to take multiple photos at the beginning at different angles, and then because otherwise what you'll have to do is you'll get the photographs and realize that, oh, well, that didn't come out the way I'd hoped. So you're gonna have to go back out to where you went, and the likeliness of you running into that same creature or same setup is not always the case. However, if you have a photo shoot it multiple times a day, you may get different looks. So that's always a good thing. But I always go through, and then the next thing I do is I will go into edit. And depending on how lazy I am, because I can get lazy with this, is which software application do I use? And if I'm doing this for a contest, obviously I would put more time and effort into it. But there are a lot of editing software pieces out there. So let me actually switch to the. Alrighty, so here are a few that are out there. This one, Pixlr, is one of a very highly rated photo editing piece of software. There is a free version as well as more advanced version. And it's just based on how many gadget and gizmos that you're allowed to have or can manipulate with. If you just want basic exposure and cropping and that type of thing, then I'll go with a free piece of software. Then you have PicMonkey. You also have Photoshop has a free version. Photoshop is probably one of the most highly rated. Besides Lightroom, those are the two that most professional photographers use in order to get their photos looking very good. So those are just a few of the many that are out there. So I'm going to switch back into. Okay, so Windows has a version of this, and this is your Windows version of software. And basically, you have what you do is you click on your folder and click on the picture you want to edit, and it'll look like this. And then this icon right here, it'll say edit, and you click on it, and it'll bring you a box. That like this, and then all the different editing features along the bottom. There is a little wand that looks like it's doing some funky things on the bottom, and you can hit it, and it's an auto enhanced version where basically it will automatically do everything at once and make the photo look as best as what the computer thinks it can. And you can slide that bar, and that's what I would do at first. However, sometimes that doesn't work, and the colors are really off, and I find that it makes it worse and not better. And so it depends on the photograph, but that's what I would originally do. And then what I would do is then you hit like details, and there's only a few things you can do. Like you have light, colors, clarity. And you basically want to go through those. And what you want is to, for the lighting, you want it to obviously have enough light to where everything comes in nice and good, but not so much light that it looks just distorted and blown out. So it looks appropriate. And then clarity, what I would do is I would make sure that you're not, the clarity, sometimes it can have the plants and other things. You'll notice that the plants start to get distorted at the far end of it. With all these different things, you want to do it. You don't want to go to the extreme. Like some of the things you can manipulate a little bit here and there and just watch the photo. Does it get better? Does it get worse? And if it gets better, then try the other details and see if those will or won't help. You can see that this is the photo that started out as, and this is what it became. And what I had to do originally is I had to crop it, because originally it was a lot bigger of a picture. This field was covered in flowers, and so I had to crop it in order to get it to look like this. Flowers are very hard to photograph, especially if they're standalone and you only get a little spike of the flower. A lot of times your camera will focus on the background and not the flower. And it's you just have to manipulate it and keep trying for the flower and try different angles and different settings. And hopefully one of those pictures will come out right. But on the original photograph, what you'll want to do is hit the little flower icon, and it'll help keep the flower in focus instead of the background. And that's using what's called depth of field. So hopefully that works for you. So basically what you do is you manipulate it, and basic editing is sliding and trying to make it look better. And obviously you can see that there's not it's not a drastic difference, but there's enough that I noticed that these two photos, this is an after editing photo and this is before. So this is what you potentially can do with limited ability. And then you have your iPhone, and your iPhone has editing software on it as well. And so what I'll do, I'll stop sharing and I'll... So your iPhone has various features on it that you can do. And what you do is you go to your photos, and you click on the photo that you want. What I do is I try to, and then you hit edit in the top. But what you want to do is you see this is the cropping, and you hit it, and you can basically make it shrink from side to side. You can use these sidebars and make it so it shrinks the photo. So I can make it so the butterfly is more zoomed in. However, the more you zoom it in, depending on your pixel ratio, like I said earlier, it can make it look really distorted. So you may have to not crop it because the butterfly itself may be really off. So just watch it. But that's what I would first do, is see if is there any way to crop it to make it look slightly better. And then what I would do is I would hit this little kind of clocky looking piece on the bottom. And then what you can do is you hit this little wand, and you can see how a bar is on the ground, but this is like the auto enhance feature, kind of like what I told you about Windows, but you can see how I'm able to manipulate it, and the colors are on the phone are changing. And I just want to make it look, by me doing this, it makes it just look a little different, but you're gonna have to do this yourself. And then what you're gonna do is you hit each of these icons, and there's different ways of, this is brightness, and this is why I was talking about distorted. Notice how when I go really bright, it distorts all the pictures and makes the photo just not right. So it's just small little adjustments, and you can always go back and add more stuff later. So there's just different dials down here that you click on. And basically what you're doing is sliding this toolbar down below in order for it to change. And you just watch the photo. And what I do is I hit most of these dials and just change it a little bit, trying to just make it a little bit better. And it took me a while to get to this point, to be honest with you. It was just a matter of taking a photo and seeing what each of these did and how they did it. And the one that I would be cautious of is contrast. I would never mess with the contrast. It just distorts the photo big time. And over time, obviously, you'll learn which things work for you better than others. Saturation is a good one to make the colors pop a little bit. Just make sure they don't pop so much that they look not unreal. And vibrance is another that you can make it look really different. And warmth is one of those where you can go orangey or bluish. You can see how it's blue. So just be cautious. Like if it's slightly orangey, what I'll do is I'll go to slightly bluer and vice versa. If it's bluer, then I'll go slight. I just want to make the photo look like it originally was in my head. So that's what you do. And there are ways of sharpness and definition which can help make the photo a little bit more sharper. It can't take a photo that's like really out of focus into focus, but it can take one that's slightly out of focus into a better focus. So that's always good. And what you can do is if you don't like it, you can always hit cancel and discard changes, and it goes back to your original phone. So then there's another program. It's this little icon in the middle called Snapseed, and you basically click on it. It's a free app that you can get, and it comes up to this. Click on the middle, and click on the photo you want. And basically, all your tools are under tools, and you click on it. And the two that I use most often are details and tune image. And basically, you click on details, and what you can do is there's a sliding bar. That you can see up at the top, where the structure is basically helps the structure of the photo makes, in other words, it makes it more sharper. And then what you do is, in order to choose the category, you can you see how that window popped up, and you can see how much it on this side when you can see how I can choose the different categories, and then it just slides. And you can see this blue up top to let you know how far you've gone and how much more you potentially can do within reason. And if you like it or don't like it, you hit the X. If you don't like it, you hit the check mark if you do. And then another tool that I use, which is very similar, you can hit the little wand again, and that's kind of an auto enhancement kind of thing. And typically I will hit that because it helps auto adjust. And basically, you can auto adjust it to where everything is done at once. And then you can go into the other features by basically dragging your finger down, and you can see how it's highlighting different things. And then you basically can adjust by moving your finger back and forth. But basically, what I do is I just go into the different things like exposure and see how the exposure is doing, and go into saturation and shadows. I would manipulate somewhat, but usually I wouldn't mess with shadows. I just give it a little bit more light. And shadows, what it does is it turns all your darker areas lighter, and it just makes it come out a little bit more. So that's always good. And there, I didn't realize, but they have a little histogram. This histogram will actually show how far your photo is from appropriate. Like what you want is a histogram that kind of looks like a bell-shaped curve in the very middle of your of here on the bottom. But this one's obviously not. But I've never messed with that, so that's a new feature that I haven't messed with. If you like it, the same rules apply. And then what you do is you hit export, and you can do save a copy or save. Save copies covers the original photograph. And so I wouldn't do that. However, Snapseed, I've noticed that Snapseed doesn't save the original photograph. It saves a new version of it in Snapseed because it's a different programmed picture. But I wouldn't 100% guarantee that. So, but Snapseed is a great phone feature. And if you have a camera, what you can do is there's a little adapter that goes into down here, and you can plug it in and slide the SD card into it. I think it's like a $10 or $12 piece that can go into your iPhone or iPad. The Snapseed works on both iPad and iPhone. And the newer iPhones do a lot more. There's a lot more features with it. There are things like Camera Pro and other things that can turn your regular iPhone into a more advanced version of itself. So that is an optional kind of thing to have out there. So going back to our photography workshop. So this is what I basically saw. This is the basic editing software for your iPhone. And the next picture that I have, or slide, which is not working at the moment, is a version of what Snapseed did. So after manipulating a photograph, because I basically have my way of editing, and everyone can do editing differently. I mean, you can crop a picture first, or rotate it, or make it look good to begin with, and then try to sharpen it and make it brighter or greener, or make the shadows come out. But you can see on this one, I obviously manipulated the shadows because it's lighter. I manipulated the colors. I have made it so it's more exposed. And the things to watch is sometimes the horizon can have these funky bands. You can notice how the blues are a little off, and then there's this kind of distorted area here. However, it was in the original one as well. So this is it's more in detail or more sharp than the other one. So this is what you can do. This is on your phone. It's called Pano. These are fun photos to take. And actually, you don't just have to go like this. There is actually a trick where you can do Pano and you hit it and you can go up like this and you can stop it. And so you can take a picture of a tree or castle or something that is big this way instead of out that way. It's a cool little trick. FYI, it's something to have fun with out in the outdoors. This is another Snapseeded photograph. You can see that this one and this one are a little bit different. You just gotta watch the colors, and that's with saturation and brilliance. Sometimes the colors can look really just too bright or too vivid. And this one almost looks unnatural, but it's very close to the original look. However, sometimes when you're manipulating this part, the portions back here will not come out as distinctly as you want them to. Sometimes you have to give and take. And so if you're manipulating something here, it may distort here and vice versa. So you're looking basically for an overall picture, and you're trying to come up with the best version. So it's just a matter of manipulating the different dials and the different pieces in order to make it come out with the best possible picture. And it may not look as good as what it appeared in real life, but at least it's something that can make it look better. I mean, editing can only do so much. It only takes it a little bit of the way. However, with Photoshop Elements or the photography or Pixlr, or one of those that's a professional version, you can edit out people. You can edit out power lines or whatever out of the photograph. There's a piece of litter in the photograph. You can completely edit it out and make it look like it was never there. However, this is a very advanced version, and And so you just, and it will cost you probably $10 to $20 a month, because those are about how much the photo editing software is. So in conclusion, have fun with it. Don't just get so bogged down in trying to make a good photo or have it go a certain way that you lose the fun. Because if you lose the fun and don't enjoy it anymore, you're not going to do it anymore. And you're like, well, that was not fun. And I mean, if you have fun with it and you're taking pictures of something that is memorable to you, and you can always edit it somewhat, and just take lots of photos. I mean, sometimes they come out, sometimes they don't, and that's life. So you can always try and erase. Try just different angles, different views, lighting, tell stories. A lot of people that have gotten really good have spent time. They've researched it. There's a whole lot of videos online of how to edit edit iPhone in particular photos, or how to manipulate the settings, or hacks that you can use in order to get a better quality photograph or iPhone or whatever. So there are a whole lot of different things out there. We have a Google site that is on our Facebook site that I will post along with these two program videos. There's another workshop coming up on September 11th at 9 a.m. and it's here on our property. I did do it on a Saturday morning, hoping that more people would show up. So if you're here Saturday morning, we'll just go around and have fun talking about photography. I'll throw in some nature-oriented stuff as well. And we can set up different things if people want to have Lego people or whatever in the photograph. If you want to bring an stuffed animal and have it be in the pictures, that's fine with me. Please register for our photo contest by September 18th. This is when I need all the photos. So if you're shooting photos right now, just get them to me by September 18th. There are four categories with three different categories in those four categories. So we have like Clever Bud, Intermediate, Senior, and there's one other, and I can't think of the other one. And then in those, we have a nature or outdoors one. So anything related to outdoors, nature, like scenery, about outdoors, that goes into one category. We have a people one that will go into a completely other one. So anything involving people will be in another. But if you take a picture of like history or buildings or items, they will go in another one. So thank you for joining me today on this Zoom, and I will see you down the road. And I will, thank you for joining me, and I will hopefully see you September 11th.